Jennifer Schuett was just 8 years old when she was kidnapped from her own bed. She survived after being attacked and left to die in a field. Schuett spent the next 20 years of her life trying to hunt down the man who nearly killed her. In a preview of tomorrow's 48 Hours, Michelle Miller explores how technology helped reopen this cold case.
For most of her life, Jennifer Schuett has lived with the searing memory of the night she was 8 years old and was snatched from her own bed.
The next thing I remember was waking up in the arms of a man that I didn't know. He was running with me, carrying me down the sidewalk.
The man drove her to a dead-end road not far from her home in Dickinson, Texas.
And then he held a knife to my throat and said, "Am I scaring you, little girl? Am I scaring you?" And then he choked me as hard as he could. I blacked out for a while. I woke up to him dragging me by my ankles, and he dropped my legs. I realized I couldn't scream, and I couldn't figure out why. I had just enough strength to throw my right hand on top of my neck, and that's when I felt this gaping wound.
Her throat had been cut, and she was sexually assaulted.
I was just left to die in a field.
The next day, children playing in that field found Jennifer. She was airlifted to a hospital and rushed into surgery.
She was the bravest little girl I'd ever met.
Sharon McBride was Jennifer's nurse. Unable to speak, Jennifer began scribbling notes to help police find her attacker.
I remember writing down that there were beer cans in the car and the brand of cigarettes that he had. Everything that I thought would help in finding him.
She wrote, "He said his name was Dennis." Jennifer worked with a forensic artist, and they created this sketch. But despite her painstaking efforts, the case grew cold. The years passed, but Jennifer's determination never wavered.
Every day growing up, I was on a hunt looking for a suspect.
18 years after the attack, Detective Tim Cromie and FBI agent Richard Renison teamed up to work on the case. They sent clothing recovered near the crime scene for DNA testing, hoping new technology would make a difference. It did.
My phone rings, and it's the DNA lab. We got a hit.
The DNA matched a convicted kidnapper named Dennis Earl Bradford. Dennis, just as Jennifer had written.
It was monumental.
And when they found Dennis Earl Bradford's driver's license photo, it was another perfect match.
It was the most surreal moment of my life.
Michelle Miller, marveling over Jennifer. Number one, it's amazing she can talk so articulately about it. And just to think of the terror and the horror that she went through. And then all these years later, normally
27 years.
Yeah, normally time works against you, Michelle, in a case like this.
Yeah, usually time is the enemy. Memories fade and evidence is lost, but not here. It actually worked for them because there were those advances in DNA technology. And here's the other rub. What? He attacked someone else. He kidnapped someone else. He went to jail for someone else.
That's why he was in
He was in the files, and that's why they got the hit.
Wow. Is she today? I marvel at this woman.
She is just fine. She has two beautiful children. She is very happily married.
Good.
And, you know,
it's
the question is...
hard to imagine living with this for 27 years.
So but she has managed to work through it because every day of her life, since this happened, she imagined getting her day in court, looking that man in the eye.
She's finally getting
Dennis Earl Bradford and telling him, "You did this to me.
Yeah.
It was wrong.
And I got you.
And
oh
I got you."
Gosh.
The question is, did she get justice? And you'll have to tune in to see.
That's called a tease.
It is a very good tease.
What an amazing story.
What an amazing story. Thank you, Jennifer Schuett. Thank you, Michelle Miller. You can
see
Michelle's full report. It's called Live to Tell, Afraid of the Dark. That's tomorrow night on 48 Hours. It airs at 10, 9 Central right here on CBS.